Well, here we are at the famous basalt columns in O'Hara Bay, and this is probably the most popular tourist destination in the Chatham Islands. Basalt columns are actually surprisingly common. You can find them all over the world. But here, in this bay, it faces southwest into the prevailing weather system here in the Chatham Islands. So they are washed clean, and they are also remarkably undeformed. Why are there columns? And the reason is that as hot things cool down, they must shrink. Hot things are in a state of expansion, and so it's completely natural for the rock to break up as it shrinks into these rather distinctive patterns. So you can end up with basalt columns that are in fact rectangular or triangular even, or seven-sided or even eight-sided, but the vast majority are five or six-sided. We can trace this lava flow for about a kilometre. This lava flowed down a gully, and it must have pondered in a natural depression here, or what is now the coast. At least two or three lava flows, we think, are involved, individual pulses, put it that way. The actual age is between 80 and 85 million years, so late Cretaceous. Mainland New Zealand's right on the plate boundary between the Pacific and Australian plates, so there aren't rocks of this age are very deformed. They'll be tilted and folded and crushed. Here in the Chathams, nothing's happened. These have just, they were erupted, accumulated, and they are exactly as they formed 80 to 85 million years ago. Amazing. So this lava relates to this Chatham volcano that erupted between 85 and 80 million years ago. So this is just a couple of lava flows associated with that big shield volcano. And within the rock, there are some spectacular holes and cavities, and these all relate to clumps of the mineral olivine. And olivine is the principal mineral within the Earth's mantle. So you could say these are little globs, little samples of the Earth's mantle that have become entrained in the basalt lava, which probably emanated from a depth of about 100 kilometres, would you believe? There is abundant olivine throughout the basalt. And when it weathers and breaks down, it forms brownish mineral masses, and then crystals pop out and you end up with these little cavities and holes. This is a fabulous place to come to. It must be one of the best spots in New Zealand. So it's lovely to behold one of the world's finest examples of columnar basalts.